My name is Vince Horne. I'm the group leader for failure analysis and accident investigation at the Quality Engineering Test Establishment. We look at national defense failures and accidents and general investigations of equipment, technical type failures, and try to help our clients understand exactly what went wrong. One of the examples of that is an accident that occurred several years ago, and that was related to an F-18 Hornet that was working at an air show. It was the day before the actual air show and they were doing a practice. It happened to be that the media was there. So lots of people taking photographs, lots of people taking video of this particular event. So in this particular event, this aircraft is coming in to do a specific maneuver. It's traveling very, very slow and it's got its nose up really, really high. And it's really interesting to see in an air show. But it leaves the aircraft in a spot where it needs to use its engines to get out of that maneuver again. The aircraft went unstable. The pilot ejected in that case, so that pilot ended up being perfectly fine. We get invited hours after an event like this occurs. We ended up getting photographs that were taken by professional photographers, video that was taken by some of the major networks, in addition to the one I just showed you here, and information from people's camera phones. And we could determine that there was things in those videos that people had captured on YouTube that we could use to help us with our investigation. What's very, very challenging but exciting and very fun about this particular job is that we are looking for something very, very small sometimes in thousands of parts. We'll have ideas that we come up with relatively early to sort of say, well, if something like an engine doesn't work, what are the possible things that would most likely cause that engine not to work? So we start with the most probable and work to the ones that are least probable. Often, what you think initially must have been something to do with this, often wrong. This particular accident investigation was very unique because there were many, many things that contributed to it. Some of them technical and some of them not. Since we had video to look at, we were trying to get as much information as we could out of that video. One of the things that we're able to do is use software. We're in a digital age now. So we wanted to be able to look at what exactly were the control surfaces, the parts on the aircraft that control how it flies. What were they doing? And exactly what did the aircraft look like as it was approaching? Because we were looking for clues as to what may have been going wrong with the engines or the control surfaces, anything that may have caused it to go out of control.
Vince est un ingénieur très méticuleux. Comme on dit en anglais, he will not leave one rock unturned. C'est une personne qui va regarder à 100% dans tous les endroits, dans tous les coins pour s'assurer que tout est couvert pour donner justement le rapport le plus complet pour que nous, on puisse justement prendre ce produit-là puis compléter l'enquête au besoin.
One of the really unique bits of evidence we got for this particular investigation was a video I saw on YouTube the morning after the accident. So this particular person wasn't on the airfield with the rest of the camera crews and the photographers, but he was in a very good spot to capture the sound that that aircraft was making when it passed by him. It happened to be the first spot where that aircraft started running into a problem with its engines. One of the things I noticed in that video is the high-pitched sound of the engines as it was first passing over this individual who was working with his camera phone. And that high pitch is something you usually only hear when the aircraft's on the ground taxiing around on the runways. In this particular video where this guy was, he captured a sound that was very, very distinct. And we ran it through initially just a quick look on a piece of freeware internet software to see, well, is there something here? And we could see something that was very unique, in that it captured a unique event in this accident. So we brought it then back to Queedy, and other people within Queedy helped us further process that. So we had people who were very, very good with sound processing. So they ended up using MATLAB to create this particular image. And what it shows So there's a little line on here that's very unique in this picture. It's the one thing that stands out, is this little line, and it splits into two. In this particular case, one engine did something different from the other engine, and the sounds of the two engines therefore went different. What that uniquely told us about this accident is this is exactly where it started, right when he throttled up the engines at the beginning. One of the things that I think is very innovative about the work we do here at Queedy is we apply all sorts of unique and independently created technology to try and solve technical problems. So what we're able to do here is apply all sorts of specialized technology that lets us look at things in a new and a novel way to try and understand the problems. And it's really, really cool to be able to find this kind of stuff on the internet. We never had that ability before. This is something that's really, really unique to being in the current day and age and being able to have the software that we have nowadays to process this kind of stuff, is that we are able to look at things that might give evidence that we never would have had an opportunity to do before.